Hello everyone, welcome to SemiConta. I got a request to talk about chiplet, so today's topic is chiplet. Let's talk about it. Chiplet is a semiconductor technology to use multiple small dies to achieve target function, which is supposed to be done by one large die. Its goal is to reduce product development time and cost by integrating multiple smaller dies in a package. A chiplet is not a package type, and it is part of a packaging architecture. With chiplet, dies could be integrated into an existing package type, such as 2.5D, 3D, fan-out, multi-chip modules. Imagine, we have one large die, and it has CPU, GPU, and RF functional blocks all in one die as SoC, system on chip. But it is very expensive and there are many challenges to make this large die. Fortunately, we can have all these functions by multiple smaller dies and economically it is more reasonable. But we need to add interface block to each die, so total die area will be more than one large die. That is a brief concept of chiplet. So, chiplet is a good solution for large expensive die, which is typically for high performance computing rather than for a small die in smartphone. A silicon node of semiconductor advanced like 45 nanometer, 16 nanometers, and even 7 nanometer, cost for large dies continues to increase. Cost for a 16 nanometer die with 250 square millimeter size is more than 2 times expensive than 45 nanometer die with same die size. And 7 nanometer die is more than 4 times expensive than 45 nanometer die. Now, we are talking about 5 nanometers and even 3 nanometers, then cost will be increased continuously. That means fabricating large SoC dies with advanced silicon node is losing its economical benefit. That is why the industry has started to use chiplet. Again, chiplet is to break down a large expensive single die into multiple smaller dies. How it works? This is simple comparison between one large die and four small dies. If there is a defect at the upper left of the die, then it is reject. One die reject out of one die, so yield is 0%. If we have four small dies and there is same defect at the exact same location, then only one die is reject out of four dies and yield is 75%. That means we still can save three dies. It is more obvious for very large die. It also works for die loss at the wafer edge. At the left, we have die loss at the wafer edge for large die. At the right, we also have die loss, but smaller die has higher yield than large die. This is die yield comparison between one die versus chiplet with 2, 3, and 4 dies. For 360 square millimeter, one die will have 15% yield, but a 4 chiplet design, each 99 square millimeters will have 37% yield, more than doubles. Even though the total die area of 4 chiplet design is more than 10% than one die, the significant yield improvement of chiplet is good enough to justify a chiplet solution. Back in 2014, FPGA company Xilinx made Vertex 7 2000T, and it used 4 smaller chiplet dies rather than one large FPGA die. This is AMD EPYC 2nd generation package, and it is a CPU for server using 7 nanometer silicon node technology. Its package size is 58.5mm by 75.4mm. Yes, it is big. There are 8 CPUs using 7 nanometer silicon technology, and one I/O die using 14 nanometer silicon technology at the center. This is Intel Xe HPC, and it is a GPU using 7 nanometer silicon technology for a supercomputer. Now, Intel is using this only in the lab. It has 47 components and include 2 base tiles using Intel's 10 nanometer SuperPin technology, 16 compute tiles using TSMC's 7 nanometer technology, 8 Lambda cache tile using Intel's 10 nanometer enhanced SuperPin process, 11 EMIB links made by Intel, 2 Xe Link I/O tile made by a foundry, 8 HBM memory stacks produced by a DRAM manufacturer. It would be impossible to build a single chip with these 47 components. Even though ChipNet has lots of benefits, it also has some challenges. We need to think about die-to-die interconnection. Code designed by chip designer and package designer is required. Tests for small dies will be different from one large dies, etc. Thanks for watching and have a nice day. Bye-bye.